In this video, I will talk about a condition called chronic intestinal pseudo-obstruction, also known as CIPO or CIPO. It is a syndrome reported in dogs where impaired intestinal motility results in clinical signs of obstruction without mechanical occlusion of the intestinal lumen. Lyomyositis has been identified as a cause of CIPO in dogs. In this condition, the myofibers are targeted, likely secondary to an autoimmune disease. Infiltration of the smooth muscle by lymphocytes and replacement of muscle with fibrous connective tissue leads to the disruption of motility, resulting in the clinical signs such as vomiting and inappetence, mimicking mechanical gastrointestinal obstruction. Zakuda et al. Described the largest case series of 6 dogs with confirmed CIPO published in Journal of Veterinary Internal Medicine in 2016. All of these dogs underwent exploratory ciliotomy due to suspected mechanical obstruction secondary to a foreign body. However, no mechanical obstruction was identified and intestinal biopsies were suggestive of CIPO. The authors recommended that an abdominal CT could be used as an adjunctive imaging modality, particularly in large breed dogs with gas distended intestinal loops, in which abdominal ultrasonography had important limitations. The median body weight of canine patients in that case series was 30.4 kilograms, ranging from 19.7 to 38.7 kilograms. In the same case series, one of the dogs initially presented with protrusion of the nictitating membrane, and histopathology confirmed lyomyositis of the third islet. The prognosis of dogs with intestinal lyomyositis is generally poor, with survival times ranging from 10 days to 5 weeks after diagnosis. Management of CIPO in dogs is not well described in the literature. However, in people it is extremely challenging and is predominantly aimed at controlling symptoms and minimizing complications. Prokinetic treatment is a mainstay of treatment along with immunosuppressive agents, such as prednisolone, cyclosporine, azathioprine that have been used in humans with documented intestinal lyomyositis. The best results have been achieved early in the disease process. In human patients with severe CIPO refractory to medical treatment, near total small bowel resection can be an effective treatment to relieve clinical signs and improve health and quality of life, although such patients remain dependent on home parenteral nutrition. So the main takeaway is that CIPO is a rare syndrome in dogs that small animal practitioners should bear in mind. Medium to large breed dogs may be overrepresented, and CT could be used as an adjunctive imaging modality in dogs with suspected CIPO or equivocal abdominal ultrasound results. Gastrointestinal biopsy is the only way to definitively diagnose chronic intestinal pseudo-obstruction, and it should be strongly considered in all cases of negative exploratory laparotomies due to suspected mechanical GI obstruction. If you like this video and you want to watch more videos like this, please hit the subscribe button below. If you want to read a full article on this topic, including a case study, go to vetmcrit.com mechanical GI obstruction fake news. In addition, you can download a free fluid therapy rate calculator by clicking the link below. Thank you, and I will see you next time.